Today we are going to see about
exercise number 3.6 part 1.
In this exercise we are going to see about factorization. Already we studied about factorization. Okay, factorization is nothing but it is a reverse of multiplication. Okay, factorization is nothing but it is a reverse of multiplication. Okay, for example I am taking the numbers 3 and 5. Okay, if you multiply, what do you get? 3 into 5, 15. This is the product. Okay, so if you are taking the number 15, it can be split into 3 and 5. Okay, so these 3 and 5 are the factors. So the reverse of multiplication is called factorization. Okay, so now if you want to factorize the quadratic polynomial, okay, we know that the quadratic polynomial is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, so it is a it has a degree, that highest power is 2, so it is called quadratic polynomial. If you want to factorize this polynomial, means first you have to find the product and sum. Okay, so that means if you want to find the product, you want to find the product of factors. Product of factors means you have to multiply the constant term and the coefficient of x square. Product of factors means you have to multiply ac, that is the constant term is c, and the coefficient of x square is a, that is the product of factors. So next one, sum of factors is nothing but coefficient of x, that is b. Okay, like this you have to first find the sum of the factors and the product of the factors. Okay, for example, if you are taking that quadratic polynomial x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay, so what is the product of the factors? Here the coefficient of x square is 1. Okay, so that is a value is 1 and b value is 5 and c is equal to 6. Okay, so 1, 5 and 6. So the product is 6 and the sum is 5. Okay, 1 into 6, 6. This is BC, the product. Okay, sorry, AC. The product AC and the sum is B. Okay, so we can choose the two numbers. It should be satisfies. The product should be 6 and the addition sum should be 5. Okay, so you are going to choose the numbers. If you are taking the number 1, 6 is 6, but if you are adding you will get 7, but here we want 5. Okay, so this is not a factors. Then you can choose 2 and 3. 2 threes are 6 and 2 plus 3 5. This is the correct factors. Like this you have to choose the factors. Okay, for that the easy way, I will give one table, you can follow that. Okay, suppose you are taking the numbers x square minus 5x plus 6. X square minus 5x plus 6. So for this, how to choose the numbers, factors? Here the product is plus 6 and the sum is minus 5. Okay, so what are the numbers we want to choose? If 1, 6 is 6. Okay, if here the sum is negative, the sum is negative. So if the product is positive and the sum is negative, means you can choose the numbers. 1 6 is 6. If you have multiply, you will get plus 6. But if you are add 7, so this is not a correct numbers. Then 2 3s are 6. Okay, so 2 3s are 6. But if you are adding, you will get plus 5. So this also not possible. Then next, what are the possibilities? 2 3. Okay, so our negative number, the product is negative, means you can choose that two numbers also positive or negative, then only you will get the product as positive. Are you clear? Nammaloada product value positive a irundhuchina choose pandra rendu numbers um onnu positive a irukano illana rendu me negative a irukano, appo da vandha namakku product vandha enna va irukum appadina you will get the positive number. Okay, so now minus 2 and minus 3. So what do you get? If you multiply minus 2 into minus 3, you will get plus 6. If you add minus 2 and minus 3, you will get minus 5. So this is the correct factors. Okay, so you can follow this a table. It is easy for you. Okay, so the numbers. Okay, then sum and product. Okay, you can choose the numbers. It is one is big number and another one is small number. Okay, so first one big number and small number. Big number, another one is small number. Okay, so this table to help, it's very easy. Okay, so you can follow this tables. So listen, if the product is positive, the product is positive, sum also positive, that means the big number and small number both also what, positive. Okay, then if the product is positive but the sum value is negative, means you can choose the two numbers also negative. Okay, then if the product is negative, the sum is positive. If the product is negative and the sum is positive, means the biggest number is positive and the smallest number is negative. Because if the two numbers are different sign, means what we have to do, if you add the numbers, okay, that means from the biggest number to the smallest number you are going to subtract, then the biggest number sign will be comes in the product, comes in the sum value. Okay, so this is the pattern. Then next one, if the product is negative and the sum also negative, so what we have to do, the biggest number is negative and the product number is positive. Okay, va, if you are using the numbers, it will be clear for you. Okay, then now we will start this exercise. 3.6. Okay, exercise 3.6, question number 1. Okay, factorize the following. The first subdivision is x square plus 10x plus 24. Okay, so first what we have to do, first you should find the product and sum. Okay, we know that here a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 10 and c is equal to 24. Okay, we know that the product is ac. You have to multiply the constant term and the coefficient of x square. The product ac is what, 1 into 24 24. Okay, then the sum is the middle term, that is first you have to arrange in the order. It is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. First of all, you should check the given question is it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c or not. Okay, if it is not there in the form, you have to arrange it first. Okay, then the sum is the coefficient of x, that is 10. Okay, now we are going to choose the two factors that must be satisfies the condition of product 24 and the sum is 10. If you know directly, you can apply the numbers, or otherwise you can start from 1 into 24, but if you are adding, you will not get 10. Okay, so this is not a correct number. Then 2, then both also positive. Okay, the sum also positive and the product also positive. See the table. If sum also positive and the product also positive, so then the two numbers must be compulsory, it will be positive. Okay, so then next, 2 into 12 2 12s are 24, but both also positive, so if you add, you will get 14. So this also wrong. Okay, then next, 3 3 8s are 24, but if you add, you will get 11. So this also not possible. Then next one, 4 4 6 are 24, if you add 4 plus 6 10. So this is the correct factors. Okay, so you have to write, split the middle term 10x. okay, so you have to split the middle term 6x and 4x. okay, for each sum you have to write like this. First you have to write the a value and split the terms, and you have to write the factors. Okay, so how can you write x square? The middle terms is split into two terms, that is 6x plus 4x, then the constant term is 24. Okay, then you can grouping the terms, two terms you can take it. Okay, so for the first two terms, what is the common term, common variable? That is x. Okay, so what is the remaining? Here x square means 1x comes outside, so remaining 1x will be there. Then x plus 6. Then for the next term, you will choose here 4x, here 24, so we can take it out, 4. So what is remaining? X. Then if you comes, if you split, there's 24 is 4 into 6 means 4 is comes outside, so remaining is 6. See, here also x plus 6, here also x plus 6. Like this, you will get your answer is correct. Okay, if you are not getting the same value for the two terms, means it will be wrong. Okay, wow. So inge enna terms namakku velila varudho adhe terms da vandu adutha pair layum varanum, andha mari vandha da namba potrukka pair vandu correct ana pair nu artham. Okay, wow. So what do you get? So here x plus 6 is common, so you can take it out, x plus 6. What is the remaining term? Here x, here plus 4. So this is your answer. Okay, if you work out more sums, it will be very easy for you. Then second subdivision, z square plus 4z plus 4z minus 12. First, what we want to check? It is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. So it is in the form. Okay, so next you can choose. Here the variable is z. Don't bother about the variable. Any variable we can use. Okay, so here a is equal to 1, then b is equal to 4, and c is equal to minus 12. Okay, so what about the product? We know that product means you have to multiply the constant term and the coefficient of x square. So that means here coefficient of z square. Okay, so what do you get? Minus 12. Okay, then the sum is positive. Okay, if the product is negative and the sum is positive, so alternate sign a vanduchu appadina enna pannuva namakku edavadhu any one of the term should be positive and another one of the term is negative. So you can choose 6 2s are 12. Okay, 6 2s are 12. So here 6 2s are 12, but it should be comes in negative. Okay, so you can choose that. If you are adding, you will get positive number 4. So you can choose the smallest number is negative. Okay, ba. Suppose you are choosing 6 minus 6 plus 2 means you will get the minus 4. So this is wrong. Okay, so if you multiply 6 2s are 12, so minus 12, 6 into minus 2 minus 12, and if you are adding, you will get plus 4. So this is the correct way. If you are not able to choose directly, you can choose, already I told you, from 1 2 3. Okay, like this you have to choose. Okay, from 1 then 2, you can 3, like this you have to choose, then you will get the correct factor. Okay, then split the middle terms, split the middle terms. As here you will get 6x 6 and minus 2. So here the variable is z. So 6 is z and minus 2 is z. So how can you write z square plus 6 is z minus 2 is z, then minus 12. Okay, you can write minus 2 is z also front, no problem. Okay, any you can choose the two numbers, no, in this any one variable you can choose front, no problem, but the common terms should be same. Here you can take two terms. Okay, so what do you get if you take at z outside? So remaining z plus 6. Okay, then here z plus 6 means that next two terms also you will get the same value. Okay, so what we can take here, minus 2 you can take outside. So z, the minus will comes outside, so we can convert it into plus 6. So here z plus 6 is the common term, you can take it out. The remaining term is z minus 2. This is your answer. Okay, then third subdivision, the question is p square minus 6p minus 16. Okay, already I told you, don't bother about the variable. Okay, any variable, any alphabet we can use. Okay, but the pattern should be same. Here a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 6, and c is equal to minus 16. Okay, what about the product? Product is minus 16. Here 1, here 16. So if you multiply, you will get minus 16, and the next term is 6. Okay, sum is 6. So what are the numbers we can choose? 2 8s are 16. If the product is negative, any one number must be negative. Okay, so first you have to choose the numbers, then you can apply the sign. If the product is negative, any one of the factors should be negative. So what are the what number should be negative, that we want to choose. Okay, suppose if you are taking minus 2, if you are adding minus 2 plus 8, you will get plus 6. Okay, but here minus 6 already in the table. If the product and the sum also negative, negative means you can choose the greatest number is negative. Okay, so you can choose it minus 8. Once again you can check it, 2 8s are 16. Here plus into minus minus, so minus 16. Then if you add, see, 2 into minus 8, you will get minus 16. If you add 2 minus 8, for subtraction, what we have to do? If you are subtracting the numbers from the largest number to the smallest number, 8 minus 2 you will get 6, the biggest number sign will be occur. So here you can put minus 6. Okay, so once you check it, then you can apply. So what about the terms p square minus 8p, then plus 2p, then minus 16. Okay, so you can split into two terms. What do you get? Here you can take p outside, then the remaining term is p minus 8. Then here you can take it out 2. So here you will get minus p, then 8 2s are 16, 2 comes already outside, so the remaining term is 8. Okay, here also p minus 8, here also p minus 8. So you can take it out. So p minus 8 into p plus 2. Okay, this is your answer. Then next question, fourth one, t square plus 72 minus 17t. See, listen, first you have to check if it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. Here the constant terms comes front. Okay, so first you have to write in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. First you have to write in the form. Here the variable is t, so you can write as the power must be in the descending order. Okay, t square, then minus 17t plus 72. Okay, if you take directly the product means it will be wrong. Okay, so first you have to write in the form of ax square plus bx plus c, then you can take it as the product under the sum. Okay, so what is the product here? 72 is the product, then minus 17, 17 is the sum value. Okay, so here we have a largest number, you can choose one by one. Okay, so what do you get here? 172 72, this is not possible. Then 2 36, this is also not possible. Okay, so because if we add, we want to get 17. Then next 3 means 2 3s are 6, remaining 12. So 2 3s are 6, remaining 12, then so 24, here also not possible. Then so what are the numbers? 72 means 8 9s are 72. Okay, so you can take it as, so 8 9s are 72. The negative sign will be in the sum value is negative, the product will be positive. So what are the possible for product is positive? Product positive irukonuna onnu rendu me negative a irukonu illa rendu me positive a irukonu, but here the sum value is negative, so both must be negative. Okay, so 8 9s are plus 72, minus 8 into minus 9 minus plus 72, if you add you will get minus 17. So you can split the middle term as t square minus 8t minus 9t plus 72. Okay, then you can split into two terms. So what are the common terms? Common variable is t, so the remaining is t minus 8. Then here you can take it as minus 9. So what about the remaining value t? Here plus means minus into minus. Okay, so one minus comes already outside, so what about the remaining t minus 8? Okay, so here also you will get the same t minus 8, so you can take it out, t minus 8. The remaining terms are t minus 9. Okay, this is your answer. Then next question, question number 5, fifth subdivision, y square minus 16y minus 80. Okay, so it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. So here a is equal to 1 and b is equal to minus 16 and c is equal to minus 80. So what about the product? Product is 1 into 80 minus 80. Okay, then what about the sum? It is minus 16. Okay, so you will get, what are the numbers we have to choose? The negative product is negative means any one of the number must be negative. Okay, so you can take it as 4 into 20 80, but it should be negative. So the sum value also negative. That means the biggest number should be negative. So you can take it as that minus 20. 20 is negative. Okay. So you can write as y square. That middle terms you can split as plus 4y minus 20y, then minus 80. Okay. First two terms you can take it as. Then y is equal to what is the remaining term? Y plus 4. Okay. Then you can take it minus 20 outside. What about the remaining terms? Minus 20 comes outside. So y, so it will be converted into positive. Sorry. Here 20 comes outside, so remaining 4. Okay. So the both terms also y plus 4. So you can take it y plus 4 outside. What about the remaining terms? Y minus 20. This is your answer. Then next question. Sixth one. A square plus 10a minus 600. Okay. So already it is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. So here a is equal to 1 and b is equal to 10 and c is equal to minus 600. What about the product? Product is minus 600 and then sum is plus 10. Okay. So it will be a biggest number, you can choose one by one. Okay. So you will get the answer 30 into 20. Okay. 3 2s are 6, then 2 zeros are 600. So what about the sum? If it, the product is negative, means any one of the number negative. So then sum is positive. Sum positive means the biggest number should be positive. So you can choose the smallest number is negative, minus 20. So you can write, it can be written as a square plus 30a minus 20a minus 600. Okay. Then split the two terms. A, you can take out a. What about the remaining? A plus 30, then minus 20, you can take it out, remaining A plus 30. Okay. So A plus 30 is the common term, so you can take it outside. The remaining term is A minus 20. Okay. So your first problem over. Then question number 2. Then question number 2, factorize the following. In the first model, all the sums a value must be 1. Okay, but in this problem, second problem, for a value also you will get different answers. Okay, so how to do the sums, we will see here. Okay, so 2a square plus 9a plus 10. Okay, the same procedure we are going to use. Okay, but here the a value here not equal to 1. Okay, we have a different values. Okay, so here a is equal to 2 and b is equal to 9 and c is equal to 10. Okay, so what about the product? Here you have to multiply 2 into 10, so that is 20. So product is 20 and the sum is 9. Okay, so what are the numbers you have to choose? Both also positive means the factors also positive. So 1 into 20, 20, but here not possible. Then 2 into 10, it will be 20, but if you add you will get 12. So this is also not possible. Then 3 is not possible to multiply 20. Then 4 5s are 20. If you add you will get positive number 9. Okay, so it is the correct answer. So it can be written as 2a square. The middle terms split into two terms, that is 4a plus 5a then plus 10. Okay, you can choose the 2 terms. Here you can take here 2a square, here plus 4a. So what is the common number? First number you can take it 2, and the a variable also is common, so you can take it a outside. So what about the remaining? A plus 4. Okay, then plus, here you can take it outside, 5. What about the remaining? A plus 2. Already I told you, sorry, here if you are taking 2 outside, it here also you will get 2. Okay, so this is the way to check our problem. Okay, here the common variables are, if you are taking outside, the variable must be equal, the terms must be equal. Okay, so a plus 2, you can take it outside. What about the remaining? 2a plus 5. Okay, this is your answer. Then second subdivision, 5x square minus 29xy minus 42y square. So here a value is 5 and b value is minus 29 and c value is minus 42. So if you multiply the product, what do you get? 5 into 42. 5 into 42, you will get 210. Okay, so that will be negative. Then the sum is minus 29. Both also negative. Okay, that means any one of the number must be negative. Okay, you can choose the numbers. You will get 6 into 35. 6 into 35. So you will get, it will be, if you multiply, you will get minus 210. So what we have to do, it will be, you can choose the numbers, two numbers, no, in this any one of the number must be negative. If you add, you will get the minus number. So the biggest number must be negative. Okay, so how can you write? 5x square minus 35xy plus 6xy then minus 42y square. For the factorization, you must practice, then only you can identify the numbers easily. Okay, directly if you are not able to find, already I told you, you can do it one by one, 1, 2, 3, like this you have to choose the numbers. Okay, then choose the two numbers, then you can take it out. 5x, what about the remaining? X, 7 5s are 35, so you will get here 7y. Okay, then next terms, here you can take it 6y. Okay, 6y, what about the remaining? X, 72, 7 6 are 42. Okay, so here you will get 7y. Then x minus 7y is the common term, so x minus 7y. Then the remaining term is 5x plus 6y. This is your answer. Then in this session, last sum, 9 minus 18x plus 8x square. See, first you have to arrange in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. So it should be in the descending order of the power. Okay, so you can write as 8x square minus 18x then plus 9. Okay, it is the correct form. Okay, first you can write the form of the quadratic polynomial, then you can find the product and the sum. Okay, so here a is equal to 8 and b is equal to minus 18 and c is equal to 9. Okay, what about the product? That is ac, 8 9s are 72, then the sum is minus 18. Okay, if the product is positive, what we have to do? the two factors must be positive or must be negative. Here the sum is negative, so you can choose the two numbers also negative. We know that 6 12s are 72, 6 12s are 72, but if you add you will get the minus 18. So what we have to do, both also negative. Okay, so you can write 8x square minus 6x minus 12x plus 9. Okay, then for the two terms you can take 2x. Okay, 2x outside. So what do you get remaining? 2 4s are 8. So remaining you will get 4x. 2 3s are 6. So 2 comes outside. So remaining 3. So minus 3. Then next term here, minus 12x plus 9. So what is the common term? Minus 3 we can take outside. Okay. So remaining what do you get? Here minus comes outside already. So you will get 4x. Plus means minus into minus. So already one minus comes outside. So remaining minus 3, because 3 3s are 9. Okay. Then 4x minus 3. Then remaining terms 2x minus 3. Okay. So in this part we are completed second sum, 3 subdivisions over. Okay. In the next part we will continue the from the fourth subdivision, second sum. Okay. Thank you, students.